Hi, I'm Professor Carrie Roberts Frith, and I'm going to be advising all of the freshmen during the 2010-2011 academic year. You'll meet me during Bobcat Student Orientation when I help you schedule your courses for fall quarter and introduce you to our curriculum here at the E.W. Scripps School of Journalism. I will be working with you during fall quarter of your freshman year. I will also be working with you during winter quarter. After winter quarter, we will transition you to an academic advisor who is more closely aligned, potentially, with your area of interest. Traditionally, we've had 6 sequences in our school. However, we've decided that in the current media environment, it is more useful for our students not to designate themselves into sort of small boxes. And our sequences are based largely on delivery of content. For example, a magazine sequence major versus a broadcast sequence major. You all will be going out into a media environment where you need to have writing and print skills, as well as video and online skills, and maybe skills that we don't even know about yet in 2010. So we are giving you the opportunity to pick a track, either a news and information track or a strategic communication track, depending on whether you're interested in news and delivering specialized information to audiences, or if you're interested in strategic communication like public relations and advertising, where you'll be working with clients to get a strategic message out to an audience. So at this point, I am available to you for questions regarding all of the course selections that you will have for 2010-2011. I'm also here to help you get involved with some of the extracurricular activities on campus and make sure that you are finding relevant activities to get involved in journalism so you can start building your portfolio to make you as competitive as possible upon graduation from Ohio University. If you're struggling with a course or you have questions about anything related to your academics, you're always welcome to get in contact with me. I do have scheduled office hours every quarter. My office is on the first floor of Scripps Hall. It's Scripps 104. If you come in from the back door with where there's the amphitheater and you look at the bust of E.W. Scripps, if you turn to the left, that's my office. You're welcome to check my office door, see when I have open office hours. You're welcome to walk in at any point with questions. Also, if you have class or other obligations during my office hours, feel free to shoot me an email and we can schedule an appointment if necessary. My email address is frith, F-R-I-T-H, at ohio.edu. I'm very religious about answering emails in a timely fashion, so that's an excellent way to get a hold of me. I will be regularly posting information for you on our school website advising page. That's www.scrippsjschool.org/advising. On that site, I will be listing a lot of important deadlines for you to think about. I'll be letting you know when advising week meetings are scheduled. Because there are a large number of you, during the fall, I will be coming to see you during your Journalism 101 class time to give you some advising information. I will also be setting up a series of meetings. You only need to come to one of the meetings where we will talk in smaller groups about what courses I recommend you take for winter quarter, for example, and then for spring quarter. One of the things that I would like to urge you to do when you first get on campus is to make sure that you attend the student activity fair. It is during the first weekend before classes start, and it is out on the college green, and there will be representatives from all of the many student media organizations on campus so that you can start thinking about not only the groups that you want to be involved in to start networking. For example, if you're interested in news and information, you'll want to join the Society of Professional Journalists, which is a student chapter of the National Organization for Professional Journalists. Similarly, if you're interested in public relations, you'll want to join the Public Relations Student Society of America, and advertising students will want to join the Ad Club. In addition to those outlets, you might also want to write and produce content for student media. Backdrop Magazine, which is a student-produced hard copy glossy that comes out every quarter. WOUB, so that you could participate in both our NPR radio station and our public television station. There are a whole variety of options where you can get hands-on creative experience working in journalism. So I urge you to attend that student activity fair. As you know, we will be switching from an academic calendar on the quarter system to the semester system in 2012, which means that you are starting your academic career here with us at Ohio University under quarters, but you will be graduating under semesters. Currently, our journalism curriculum is structured under a six-sequence model. Those sequences for news and information are broadcast, online, magazine, and news reporting. And then we also have public relations and advertising, which are strategic communication disciplines. We as a faculty looked at the transition from quarters to semesters as an exciting opportunity to update our curriculum and make it even more relevant to you as you look forward to media careers in the future. We decided that having those specific designations of the sequences, which were, at least in news and information, largely based on the delivery system in which you would be producing the content, a magazine versus a television broadcast, those designations are no longer important in an era when you journalists will be producing all different types of content for diverse kinds of audiences using all different kinds of delivery mechanisms, perhaps even delivery mechanisms that haven't been invented as I sit here in 2010 and think about our curriculum. So we have taken our six sequences and created two different tracks. So you'll be graduating under the track system. You can choose either the news and information track or the strategic communication track. Strategic communication will be for those of you who would like to work in public relations and advertising. You will be serving the needs of clients who are trying to get strategic communication messages out to distinct audiences. For those of you who are interested in the news and information side of things, you want to be a traditional journalist who's trying to get important information out to the public about our democratic society, you will choose that news and information track where you're taking courses in all different types of content creation and learning about different tools for delivery so that upon graduation, you will be equipped to work for a broad spectrum of media outlets. We have structured our track system so that all of our students will take the journalism core curriculum, regardless of which track you eventually select. And then you take some skills courses in each of your individual tracks. You also take some electives. And your senior year, all of you within your individual tracks get to pick from a small number of courses that we call capstones. In that capstone experience, we will allow you the opportunity to take all of the tools that you've learned in the classroom, out on your internship, and in student media, and bring them together to create some portfolio-worthy projects. Those capstone courses I like to think of as dress rehearsals. We're giving you the opportunity to do a professional job in either news and information or in strategic communication, present them to an audience or to a set of clients, and stand behind your work. And you get to do that professional work with the security of having a professor or a team of professors helping you make sure that you are ready to do that job out in the real world upon graduation.